Hello, I'm Billy, the Hamilton T1 account manager, and today we want to talk about setting up the Hamilton T1 and how to run the pre-op checks. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the exhalation valve and how to insert it. You turn your vent around to the port, you put it in, all the way in, you take 1/4 turn to the right and you'll hear a click. And it's in. Always check to make sure it's tight. So that's the exhalation valve. So now we have the circuit, and as you'll notice, we'll have a sleeve on the circuit. This keeps everything uniform and keeps the lines from getting tangled. So to put the circuit on, it'll only fit on one direction, and it's designed that way on purpose so we can't get mixed up. Then you've got what we call your flow sensor lines. You've got the white hookup and the blue hookup. They're color-coded, so you cannot mess them up. That's the circuit. Now we're all set to go. You're ready to run the pre-op check. The pre-op check is a tab on the main screen. You run this pre-op check anytime you are placing a new circuit on the ventilator or anytime you're placing the vent on a new patient. Now we're ready to perform the pre-op check. At that point in time, we will press the pre-op tab and have our indications for tightness, flow sensor, and O2 cell. The O2 cell is only performed as indicated by the ventilator. So the first test we will run will be the tightness test. So you always want to make sure, because you will be occluding the circuit, that you have a glove on your hand. Press tightness and you follow the commands. Tighten patient system. So at that point in time, with your gloved hand, you tighten the system or occlude the circuit. Follow the commands on the screen. As indicated, that was ramping up the pressure and that was the safety valve. We passed the test as indicated by the green arrow. Our next test will be for the flow sensor. So, you press the tab. You've got a connector on your flow sensor. Take the connector off and turn the flow sensor as indicated by the screen. The flows will slowly ramp up. The command say to turn the flow sensor again, so we will turn them, remove the connector and replace it onto the circuit. Once again, we get the indication with the green check that the pre-ops are complete. If you received a red X in either one of the boxes, that indicates a failed test. At this time, you should check your circuit from the flow sensor all the way back to the ventilator to assure all connections are tight. You should also remove your exhalation valve, check the membrane for proper positioning, reinsert it and tighten it. Attach your circuit and rerun your pre-op checks. After passing your pre-op checks, you're ready now to set your controls, place your filter in line, and begin ventilation.